What's up, no glutubers? We are here today to show you how to make the dough for the best gluten-free pizza that you will ever have. You're going to need a mixing bowl. You're going to need a spatula to work the dough once you get the flour and all the ingredients in the bowl. A spoon to scoop out the flour. I have a pretty big bag. You'll need some measuring spoons, some measuring cups. I have a 4-cup and a 2-cup. You will need some containers in which to take your dough and give it some time to rise. We'll walk through that at the right time. And then you'll need a scale, and you'll need one that is able to go to grams. Let's go through the ingredients of what goes into making the dough. You'll need gluten-free caputo flour that you can buy. We buy ours at Wegmans or Amazon. You'll need room temperature water. You need yeast. We use Fleischmann's active dry yeast. You'll need baking soda, olive oil, and salt. First thing that we're gonna do before we mix anything, we're gonna take care of the water because we wanna add the yeast to the water first to get the yeast activating with the water. So we need 300, we're making 4 pizzas. We need 382 grams of water. So I'm adding my water weight to the weight of the measuring cup. Mine happens to be 588 and 382, so I'm looking for 970 grams of water. So it calls for 1/2 teaspoon of yeast. So a nice level 1/2 teaspoon. Add that in. I like to stir it a little bit, get it activated, and then you're gonna set the water aside. We're gonna get the flour weighed and into the bowl. So we need 500 grams of caputo flour, gluten-free caputo flour, to make 4 pizzas. So I've got my 4-cup measuring cup here, weighs 837 grams. I need 500 grams of flour. So I'm going to, in my case, 1,337 grams. So I'm just gonna scoop until I get to 1,337. Flour weighed and measured, we're ready to add that to the bowl. So I'm just gonna take that, add it in. 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda. Take our measuring spoon, get a nice level 1/4 teaspoon, put that in there. All right, next is 2.5 teaspoons of salt. I just use regular table salt, so get that in there. Baking soda, and we're just gonna mix that dry mix together with a fork. Next step is to add your olive oil, 1.5 tablespoons into the dry mix that you've mixed up. So we got 1, and then I eyeball the second for 1/2 and 1/2. And then next, we are gonna take the water and yeast mixture, and we're gonna add that into the dry mixture. Okay, now we have all the ingredients in the bowl. We're gonna mix it by hand. Just take a spatula, make sure you steady your bowl with your other hand so you don't work it off your countertop or surface. And what we're looking for is a uniform ball of dough that all of the dry flour has been mixed into. Been about 3 minutes of mixing, and we have a nice ball of dough. Now we're gonna transfer the ball of dough onto the countertop and the flour that you prepared. And you're just gonna work it out with your spatula, and it'll all come out. It looks sticky, but it doesn't stick to the bowl as much as you think it would. You're gonna wanna make sure you have some flour on your hands. So I just take my hands, pat it in the flour, rub them. Now we're gonna take this ball of dough and we're gonna finish it. So we're gonna roll it in the flour a little bit. Not too much, just cover the surface. Then I take the remaining flour, just push it out of the way. Save that, you might need it as you start to break this one ball of dough into 4. Okay, now I'm gonna take it, pat off the remaining flour, and start to shape it in my hands. Now what I like to do is I take the ball of dough, put it on my countertop, and roll it out 2, 3, 4 times with my palm, mostly with the heel of my palm, to get into the center of it. First, get a little bit of flour onto your knife surface, then cut. So just get in the center line, press down, pull, and then release the ball of dough for the knife. Okay, so now we're gonna go through the same process we did when we had a single ball of dough. Take it, we're gonna shape it, roll it between our palms and our hands. Okay, so now we're gonna take the ball of dough that we halved and we're gonna half it again. Cut, pull, release, a little bit of flour, roll it. So you are done. The next step is to take your ball of dough, I take a little bit of olive oil, squirt it onto the bottom of a Tupperware, roll it around with my fingers to prevent sticking during the rising process, and then take that ball of dough, place it in the center of the Tupperware. Loosely cover, do not put in the refrigerator. I leave out for approximately 4 to 6 hours. It will rise nicely and it'll be ready to cook. All right, everyone, that concludes the tutorial on how to make the best gluten-free pizza dough that you will ever have. To impress your neighbors, friends, relatives. Have fun, it's easy to do, it tastes great. And remember, if you like what you saw, like and subscribe.